Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials. Today, a 10-minute mini walkthrough on GS DSP's Quantum Distortion. So just before Christmas, I reviewed Quantum Delay. Maybe check out my video on that. That's similar to this, but it's a delay, really nice little app. I also did a detailed video on Magic Delay. And in that Magic Delay video, I looked at the modulation section in detail, so you can go and watch that if you want to learn about the modulation section. I'll mention something else about that, some new addition, in a minute. So, also, I've got giveaways on YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, and my Patreon. Those giveaways are mostly for winning the iOS version of the app, but on my Patreon I've also got a giveaway for desktop. All links, etc., are in the pinned comment. The winners will be picked in 2 days. If you missed the giveaway and you're watching this video later, maybe subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on other giveaways. So let's look at this. So this is a really nice distortion effect. Now I'm on the default patch, and in the default patch nothing is turned on. So we could, well, let's look at this first of all. So here we have what's called the XY mixer. So if we look at the app, we have four different types of distortion. So here drive, here ring mod, here bit crush, and here downsampling. We have level sliders for each one here also. And then here is where we can mix between those different effects. So if I pull this down here, so it's on the bottom left, right, the little red circle, that is gonna just have ring mod. So if I bring ring mod in, now we're hearing that ring mod, but it's not all that noticeable. So let's bring up this level control. And now I can play with the frequency for that. Until I get something that sounds good. Okay, and then if I drag up to the top left, now we have drive, and so let me bring in some drive. At the moment there's no drive applied. And you know, you have things like tone controls and filters, so here a low pass filter. Okay, so if it's a bit too shrill, you can use that tone control. Okay, so that's a bit too shrill, so I bring down the low pass. Okay, now over here, bringing it over to the top right, we have the bit crush. And this little thing here called bit warp. So we can see down here what that does. Distributes the bit resolution across the level. Turn to the left to assign more bits to low levels. Turn to the right to assign more bits to the high levels. And again, tone controls and filter and level. Okay, now pulling this down here, down sampling. Interpolation, sample and hold, tone control, jitter, bringing in a bit of randomness, level there, whoa. Bring in the filter maybe. Oh, Okay, now let's go through a few presets. And remember also that you've got, you know, different randomizations and stuff in these GS DSP plugins, like you can gently randomize. Randomize a lot. Notice also here, okay, filters on the input level, but also this little more section. So let's hear what that's like up on both. So if you press this one, that'll light up, and then you want more, you have to press here. Bring those down. Dry wet control. Here we see modulation assignments, so there's no modulation assigned in the default patch. So, a few presets. So we can see the modulation going on here. We can see this is an amplitude follower. This random oscillator. So amplitude follower, if we click here, we can see that is assigned to this. That's the ring mod. If we click in on this one, random oscillator, that's assigned to this, the frequency for the ring mod. So you set up modulation here, and I'll just point out this has some new modulation type on it, and I think their other apps have also been updated to have this. So if you're using the iPad, you can have 3D motion, so it can use your accelerometer and stuff like that. So when you tilt the iPad, it will increase or decrease the modulation. So remember, they also have some app with just their modulation system in it. There's a free version and there's a more expensive paid version. Well, not more expensive than free. It's still cheap though. So again, if you're not familiar with how their modulation systems work, you can watch my Magic Delay video. Also, if you want to check out a nice free distortion app for iOS, check out the video I did on Primo last week. Totally free, very good distortion app, but this one is much, much more powerful in terms of modulation. I mean, they've both got their own nice little unique things about them. So these are guest presets by some person called Zanshin, maybe? And so look, you see you can also modulate the XY mixer. And parameters are exposed as well here, so you can use external LFOs and stuff like that as well. If you're not familiar, by the way, I'm using iPad here. I'm using the host AUM, available for iPad and iOS. I've got a very detailed walkthrough on this as well. Just check out my archives or just type in AUM Gavinsky. Nice preset naming. So there we go, yeah. The modulation system in the GS DSP apps is really top tier. I can't think of any other iOS apps that have such a good inbuilt modulation system. Okay, so there you go. That's a nice quick overview as promised. Hope you enjoyed it. Please smash the like, etc. everyone. If you like my channel, and especially if you've been a fan for a few years, if you have, won apps and stuff in giveaways, please consider giving something back by joining my Patreon, and you will also get a lot of exclusive videos, lots of giveaways, including desktop plugins, and a great little community. Okay, see you later. Thanks for watching, folks. Bye.